In the last video, I showed you how to reduce the two-body problem to a one-body problem using the center of mass coordinates. We got the equation for the center of mass, capital R, meaning that its acceleration is zero. And we got the equation for the relative position vector of the two masses, R double dot, equals minus k r vector over r cubed. We need to continue with this now to get the system of equations that we're going to solve in MATLAB. So we need to do certain things like define our coordinate system and define our initial conditions of the masses. And so basically, to do a numerical problem, you have to specify everything before you sit down at the computer and try to solve it. So we're not quite there. So the first thing we're going to do is use what's called the center of mass coordinate system. Center of mass coordinate system. So we know that the acceleration of the center of mass coordinate is zero. So that means that r is moving at constant velocity. We're going to make our coordinate system also move at constant velocity, so that in that coordinate system, then r dot will be zero. And then we're going to put the origin at r equals zero. So the center of mass coordinate system is the coordinate system where this r vector is just the origin, right? The zero vector. Okay. Two, you can show that if the motion, if the position of the masses are start in the xy plane, so we define the xy plane to contain the initial position of the masses, and also the initial velocity vectors of the mass, so the masses themselves and their velocity vectors sit in the xy plane. We can always do that with the two-body problem. Then the motion will always be in the xy plane. So here we only need to consider two-dimensional motion, so the motion in xy plane. So that means we're setting essentially z equal to zero. Okay, three, we have this k here. So three, we can choose units to solve this problem in. K has some dimension, and if we choose units using K and using also the minimum distance between the masses, it's equivalent to solving this problem where we can just set K equal to 1, and then the minimum distance between M1 and M2, we also define that to be 1. So doing this is essentially choosing units for time and length to simplify the equations, okay? Fourth is to set up the orientation of the coordinate system. So we have our XY coordinate system. I'm going to set up the orientation of the coordinate system. So say at t equals zero, our mass is sitting here. So this will be zero here. This is going to be the minimum distance. So this will be minus one in this coordinate system. And the velocity vector is going to be parallel to y. So the mass is going to be moving upward when it's at its minimum distance to the origin, okay? Minimum distance to the origin. Okay, so when we do that, then finally we get our differential equation. This is a differential equation for x and y. The final differential equation will be x double dot equals k will be 1. So it will be minus x over r cubed, which is x squared plus y squared to the 3/2. The x component, the y component then would be y double dot equals minus y over x squared plus y squared to the 3/2. So this is our coupled system of differential equation, two coupled second order equations. That will be equivalent to four coupled first order equations. And those four first order equations is what you will solve in MATLAB, okay? The other thing we need is the initial conditions. So the initial condition here will be for x of 0, right? That will be equal to minus 1. Y of 0, we're setting up the coordinate system, so initially it's at y equal to 0. Then the initial velocity, so x dot of 0, the initial velocity is going to be in the y direction, so that's equal to 0, and then y dot of 0. So this is the variable that depends on what the orbit looks like. If you do some further analysis, which I won't do here, you can show that that's equal to the square root of 1 plus e. Okay, so we write the initial y velocity in terms of e, where e is the eccentricity of the orbit. Okay, so what that means is that e equals 0 corresponds to a circle, and e between 0 and 1 corresponds to an ellipse. So those are the two types of closed orbits, okay? So if you start off with a velocity of 1 in these units, you'll end up with a solution that's a circle around the origin. If you start off with e that's between 0 and 1, so a velocity that's between 1 and 2, and you'll end up with an ellipse, okay? One more matter. If you go further in the mathematics, you can calculate what the period of these orbits are. The period is the time it takes to complete one orbit, and that will turn out to be 2 pi divided by 1 minus e raised to the 3/2 power, okay? You can actually work all of this out using an earlier reading problem I gave you where you computed the Keplerian orbits using a root finding method, okay? You can go back to that earlier problem and work out all these orbits in terms of the ellipse and also work out the period. But I give it to you, okay? So this is your problem to solve numerically. What you need to do then is you have your differential equations. So you have second order equations for the x position and the y position of this one body problem. You have the four initial conditions that you need. You can vary the type of orbit that you consider by varying e between values, say, between 0 and 1 for a closed orbit. You know how long you have to evolve the solution to get a one period of the solution. You're basically all set now to go and do the numerics, right? Remember how to write the second order equation in terms of two first order equations. Have a look at the description of the project. Have a look at my skeleton of the code that I give you. And then the end result then will actually, once you solve for x and y, you want to construct x1, y1, and x2, y2, and then plot the motion of the two masses. So you want to go then from the one body problem back to the two-body problem. So you can visualize how these two masses move around each other. The two-body problem is the planet and a sun. It's the planet and a moon. Or, for instance, you can have some solar system where there are two suns and the two suns orbit around each other. A very interesting physical problem. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.